Right, so I'm going to do a guide for Cult of the Viaduct. All of these spots will probably be better with mini sentries for obvious reasons, but I will show them off with level 3s, and they potentially could be viable level 3s. I'll probably be doing this from a competitive perspective, so I'll be using spots that are effective in comp generally, and that I usually would use mini sentries for, but I'm just going to show with level 3s. Through the power of witchcraft, I have an obscene amount of health and infinite ammo and metal, so.
Teleporter going up.
I build a telly at the spawn there because nobody uses the side entrances. One of the best spots for teleporters on this map is on this shelf, which you get by building the dispenser here. So you come out of spawn, place your teleporter, go to the supply cabinet to get more metal, so you come out with a full 200. Spend 100 on this dispenser, go over here to grab the metal there for the 125 for the teleporter. Hop up on the dispenser and jump and just put that on the shelf. You can either upgrade that by going on there to, or going up the dispenser and upgrading it through that, but that takes a bit of time. I generally bob the dispenser and walk out and probably put a mini about here, or about here. That's from a comp perspective anyway. If you want to upgrade that teleport, you can either go to spawn or you can use the dispenser and stay up there, or... obviously this map's different, there's a little area that you can go through on the comp version of this map. However, you can... Oh, did they actually... Is this a only comp only thing? Oh no, there we go. You can actually hop around and get to the teleporter from here. A little jump spot you can use. Scouts will use that to break this, or spies, or any class that can't rocket jump or sentry jump to get up here. Pyro can debt jump up here, I believe. I haven't actually tested that. So the telly's level 3 there. That's arguably the best spot on the map for the teleporter. There is a lot of different places you can put it though. I've had it here before, but I've got people killed because of it, because people will push down these stairs into the... You'll check that right side, you can see people's heads. At least in... Well, it's not a bad spot. If you can't get up there. If your telly gets destroyed up there, it's a bit of a pain in the neck to get the teleporter back up there, because you'll be mid-round and they'll be fighting all over the point. I'll demonstrate that later. A telly in the house isn't bad. Just here. Obviously it's... You can't see it, I don't think, unless you're looking through one of those windows. But it's obviously quite easy to sap from there. You can build a teleporter on the cliff here. It looks like you can't, but, well, might be different. I think those bushes and this ramp's slightly differently angled for comp, but you can build one here, which will get your teammates funneling onto the point relatively quickly. All these spots are pretty good. I've never really built on top of this balcony before. I don't think it's particularly viable, because you'll get sniped as you come out of it. You can get sniped coming out of the teleporter there, but it's an awkward angle and people don't check it that often. Comp, the dispenser usually goes about here. It can go there, I don't know, I keep going over the metal, it's force of habit. You can build it there. That's a good spot if you're struggling to hold any further forward. I've seen it built. I was playing a lobby couple of matches back, and I think it was built here or here. That's if you're holding further back. You can build one on the cliff somewhere, depending on where your teammates want it. Generally, though, ideally you want it behind the point here. This is generally where you'll find most of them. Since this is normal viaduct, you can build it in this area here, anywhere here. So then you can grab the 100 to replace it, or in the other corner. Yeah. Personally, I wouldn't use the Wrangler on this map, but that's a personal preference. You can have some effect from wrangling from China on the comp version of this map. That particular metal grate there, it doesn't exist. And this is the same, I believe. So, a common spot I see people build here is this area here. I keep going over the metal, which, it does cover the point quite effectively, but if their team has a competent sniper or can cover cliff, or they've got people up cliff, it can be very difficult to deal with them, especially since the Wrangler got nerfed and its bullets don't do as much damage as usual. You can keep that there, but unless, well, it depends on the level of players in your particular public game. An Uber coming around this corner will completely mow down everything here, because the heavy will be coming round like this, unless he does get picked up by a sniper up there. That's not a bad sentry spot. I personally would probably build... I will be showing off, or attempting to show off, this spot here, where the sentry will just hopefully It's quite difficult to see from the other side of the point, which I'll show. It's even worse with minis. See, you can't even see it here, but this will shoot people on the point and slightly behind it as well, I believe. And the more you upgrade it, the taller the sentry gets, so show that real quick. So the dispenser should be to my left at the moment. Obviously it's not built because I'm moving it around quite a lot. So this is a level 2. See, you can just about see it from here, and it'll probably shoot at people from here. I'm not 100% sure on the range of it.
Packing up.
Yeah, it will shoot people from about there. You can always move it slightly further forward. Obviously it'll be easier to spot, but will more likely to hit people. If you're coming from this side here, until you get to about here, you can't even see this entry. So you either have to know it's there, or it will probably shoot you if you try and edge it from that angle. I believe it is slightly exposed from the cliff. I'll check that real quick. You can hop up this cliff, at least in the comp version, if you can in this, but you can if you're actually decent at jumping. Yep. You can see it from cliff, but you probably can't see the engineer who will be behind it, and probably about here, either rescue rangering or punching it. I don't know if I'll run the angler particularly when I'm actually doing the live stuff. I probably will, just because the ability to shield it is just too good to sacrifice. If you're running minis, of course, probably going to run the pistol. I'll take a note of how much higher this is up, and see, the thing is with this, you can potentially drop it further back and it'll still cover the point because it's so tall, the level 3 compared to the level 1. It has the same hitbox, but it's tall because of those little suction cups. So you can see here, you can only see the top half of the sentry really. From this side, you can see the entire thing, but you'd have to be in its line of fire to be sort of seeing that. I'm going to pick it up real quick and see how far back it covers on that side.
I'm moving this.
Yeah, it literally reaches those crates, so you can't peek that my right currently. It would be the left-hand side of the map.
That was getting hit.
Or the right-hand side of the map if you're building on this side. Oh no, it's to the left. This map's mirrored. In near enough, I think that rocks, like, one of those rocks is better for a soldier. Anyway, so a sentry here is probably what I'm going to be using. There's plenty of spots that you can use that will surprise people. In comp, I occasionally will build a mini here.
There wasn't getting any lighter.
Whilst it doesn't look like a good spot or anything, but it will surprise people coming off cliff. It doesn't cover that, well, my left if I'm facing this way. It doesn't cover that side at all, but it does cover almost all of the area around it. And it does cover that side to some extent, excuse me. Another spot that people don't expect is here. Because it's right up against the house, and unless they're looking out that window, and even then I don't think you can see it. Let's have a look. You can hear it. You can see its shadow. Oh, Valve, and you're clipping shadows. How much of a giveaway you are. This spot's good, though, because if you look, it covers the entirety of the cliff. It basically covers the entire point, but it's very close to the walls, so it can be blasted with fire and stuff like that from the edges, probably. I don't really have a demonstrator or anything like that with me. Maybe another time. Who could probably edge that sentry with a flamethrower or something.
Moving out.
Another cheeky spot that you can do is up there. That's good for minis, particularly. A level 1 there will do some good work. Obviously, level 2 and level 3 have got a long upgrade time, but putting on that shelf will surprise people to no end. And it will also break the teleporter if there's another good engineer on their team.
Packing up.
Who knows about that spot? Show you the... I can't really show it without, like... Can I go in third person?
Out of my way!
Third person. Yes. So, if you can... See if you still can't really see it even here. I'm trying to get the arcing cone. Hold on. I'm trying to get to give you an idea of how much it will cover on this right side. It doesn't seem to want to show it. Yeah, it's weird. If I fix the camera, maybe I can do it. Hold on. That didn't work at all. Okay, man mode doesn't seem to want to be working with me right now.
There wasn't getting any lighter.
So, this spot, it's not bad for mini sentries and stuff. It'll plink at people and they won't know where it is exactly, but...
I'm moving this.
I'll get out of third person in a minute. It's not going to be particularly effective unless the team you're playing against doesn't expect it, and it's quite high leveled. It will only shoot at people in a certain radius as well, which is kind of annoying. Another spot that I use occasionally is, I don't believe, you can get a level 3 here. You can get minis even further nestled back than that, and it will cover the entirety of this right side, and anybody who decides to walk any further forward. I will probably try and get a sentry there at some point when we've suppressed them enough. I don't see this one often because I don't run level 3s in Highlander or anything, but you could probably put one on this far right side and it'll cover. It almost reaches that doorway over there, so this is an entirety cover of the right side here. Obviously it ignores the left and the pawn. Well, moving out. I can't really tell. It will cover the point from here to some extent. Heavy load coming through. Which will be a nasty surprise for anybody running on it. This map's pretty good for basically any sentry of any kind, really. Level 1s and stuff I will be using personally, but mini sentries will do even more work because they're mini sentries and they are built around being offensive. So aggressive spots like here, there, maybe even here. I personally wouldn't put one right below cliff, but it would be a bad idea. So if you want a good defense of Viaduct, you want a sentry either here. You can make it work here, but you've got to be mindful of cliff. A sentry there can be a nasty surprise. I'm talking about minis mainly. One up there can be pretty good. And there's messages. And one on the right hand side here. So, yeah, in summary, that's pretty much the pre-game, pre-live, pre-blah blah blah stuff of this part. You can build them on top of there, actually. That's the part I didn't show. I think you can build tallies up there as well. It's a bit of a time-consuming spot to get stuff up to, but I don't believe it can be seen from cliff. I will check that real quick. Obviously, you've got to have overheal and stuff. I just have a oscillator health because of particular commands I use to do a little exploit. Well, it's not an exploit. It's adcon 74, and then I did adcon 75, then removed it because that makes you... Well, adcon 74 makes you big. Adcon 75 makes you little. Removing the adcon 75 makes you normal sized and gives you one, keeps you with 1250 health. It's based on your class's percentage. I believe it's 10 times as much, and it also gives you limited ammo and metal, mainly unlimited ammo. So you can't see the teleporter from there, so that's not a bad spot for it, but it's a little bit harder to get up there unless you've got some free time on your hands, and obviously you've got to upgrade it. I do believe you can cover the point from there. I will check that very quickly. I'll bullet jump with a level 1. Perfectly capable of doing that. Come on, come on, position. I'm just going to no-clip up there because I'm terrible. I could have just taken the telly. You can get away with a level 1. Is there anything going to pull that? Sentry going up. So I believe you could cover the point with this to some extent. I probably personally won't be using this spot because it's a pain in the ass to get to, and I can do just as well with other spots. But this would be a nasty surprise for anybody. I don't know how effective it being proper comp, because I believe that column that holds up the bridge is slightly shorter and exposes you to cliff, and this is a walkthrough area, so you'll have people coming underneath you. You can probably cover almost all of point unless they're capping on the very far right there behind the pillar. So, say if I had a level 3 with rockets and stuff, I could probably still cap it from here. See, the sentry only just about reaches this point. Might be able to hit people with rockets and stuff, but then they could just potentially position themselves over here. Right, oh yeah, one more. This is pretty good. And that looks broken as all hell. Fix your sentry models, Valve. When they're building in weird spots, they tend to, like, not have half their legs. But yeah, you can build on top of this little rocky area here. I might mess with that. Obviously, it's exposed to cliff still. So yeah, that's about it. You've got up there, outside the house, there. Here's probably the best spot on this map, personally. You can obviously hold the point quite well with the sentry here, but once again, exposed to snipers, you're a bit better off behind here, where you're less likely to be hit by them. Dispenser generally goes here in that corner or the back corner there, and teleporters on the shelf, on the left, on the right, or in the house, wherever you can get them, or over there. You can just pile an entire nest in that area if you really want to. And there's that little roof area, and that's basically it. I will go to the live now. I'll probably play about 3 rounds and I'll either edit them together or I will just do three straight rounds in a row to see how people adapt to the tactics I do. Right, okay. Alright, so we're on a fresh round. We're at the very, very beginning of the map. Also, particle glitches. So, we'll get us started quick. We'll grab the teleporter and the metal, as I said.
Erecting a dispenser.
Hopefully get this telly on the shelf without getting harassed to death. Or completely fail and miss the jump. Probably get backstabbed. So I need 30 more metal and the scouts are just going to crap on our team for a bit. They've got the point, so I'm going to play as defensively.
Building a sentry.
Can I get a sentry up? Got a sniper over there. So the sniper's dead.
Keep going! Sentry right overhead!
Get us up to level 2 and I'm going to move it onto the point. Move it next to the point. Using the rescue ranger. Just gonna get this quick switch. You can see the sentry is completely denying the point pretty much. I need to move it slightly to the right though. Get the dispenser up.
We have captured the control point.
And it's been sniped at as well. It's slightly misplaced. It needs to be backed up.
Moving out.
There we go. Grab more metal.
Go, go, go!
As you can see, I've got the dispenser going on behind the point, and the sentry is covering the point. Should make for a relatively easy time. Position that slightly better. Oh, so the teleporter's level 1, I'll upgrade that when I die. Don't know exactly where their team is, but they're playing it quite defensively. I'm just going to keep out for an eye out for spies now. Make sure I don't get sniped as well. Wait for the metal. This is a very leisurely sort of game, so... I think we're quite far forward at the moment. This would be a time to move up, actually.
Packing up.
Get this entry in a very aggressive position. Like here. So a sentry hits some of my rockets there. So I've got to make sure I've got enough metal to rescue Ranger 8. It's killing people on cliff now. Just gonna watch my back from spies. So my dispenser's level 3, my telly's level 1, but it's on the shelf, so I can't really go back and upgrade it. So I've got a nice forward hold here, and I'm ready to pull the sentry out if needs be with the rescue ranger. Obviously, if you wanted to get really aggressive, I'd move it even further forward. But currently it covers the point on every other angle. Heavy's coming out of that door there. I was raining down death with the airstrike. I'm just listening to the sentry's bleeps now and getting ready to repair it as needs be. Just watch for spies. If it gets sapped, it goes down. Pretty much that. This is relatively easy. See, eventually the rescue ranger, it does quite easily arc projectiles, so you can quite easily destroy mini sentries and stuff. So you can see I'm completely suppressing the entire map right now with just this sentry. Okay, Mackinac guy's taking pot shots. I'm just rotate over here. Stand under this, so he can't see me unless he literally comes in my line of sight. And people are calling for a team scramble. Vote no against this for now, just to get this round over. I'd like this round to finish, so I've got one decent round at least. We'll see how it goes. So if we upgrade the teleporter there, I would have got more points. Obviously this is a very, very leisurely round of viaduct, but the same strategy applies with mini sentries and comp and stuff. I will show probably a comp viaduct game at some point just to sort of combine these. I'll stay on red for now because there's no room on blue and it seems like they got some more people. So hopefully they can get something done. I should have read this telly to start. Also because the TF2 is a buggy game, it sounds like there's one already been built here, which there isn't. Keep an eye on the scoreboard while we wait, just as sort of reconnaissance of who's up, who's not. See, we've bled two people, they've still got presence. We've got a heavy with a hero long going huge. That's done. Oh, there's a power out of spawn. We'll get bored. Unbreakable teleporters, yay! The best kind of teleporters. Never go with the rescue ranger. At least there's a weapon. Well, they got the point now, so this is going to become slightly more interesting. I'm going to have to proceed with caution. Got him. That's a load of stickies. I can't walk any further forward. Because that would happen. I'm going to attempt to build up here. Use this dispenser as a forward heal. Wait until we get some presents. This pyro burns people. And no one can kill him apparently. And he's got Chris. He knows how to use it. I'm going to run. Because he's going to walk straight towards our spawn. The problem is, I should have gone out there and got a sentry up early. God, don't make me range this fucker. There's two of them. Back in spawn, grab the help. I might go soldier in a minute just to clear the spawn. I'm just gonna. No, I've got a level 3 tally out there.
Hell of a shot, mister!
See, we can't seem to counter the wall of pyros at the moment. I'll get a level 1 up here. Obviously it's not as far forward as I'd like it to be, but it will cover the point. Or it'll cover the immediate area. There's a rescue range to keep it topped up. So as you can see, this is giving us a little bit of a slightly further forward hold. The guys in main are being harassed by it. I've got a level 1 dispenser waiting here. Problem is now, they know where it is. I'll get this to a level 2, then I'll move it close to the point. Pyro's coming. Running into the sentry, or wisely done. So as you can see, we're holding a little bit further back now, and I've got to try and get the sentry in place so my team can cap the point. Wait for a bit of reinforcement. I'll be a spy now. Right, I'm going to get aggressive here. Grab a bit of metal from the dispenser as I go past. Soldier's capping, I'm behind him. Get me back up. My gun will go up quick enough.
Moving out!
Give that soldier a little boost on his way to the point.
Mission ends in 30 seconds. Keep going!
I need to get my tally up if possible. Stickies nearby. Destroy the stickies with the Wrangler. Not easy, but it's doable. Need to get the tally up. Direct hit's gonna take it.
Right,
yep. Someone needs to do heavy on point. Get track. Which he can't. And that's me done. Time to get out. This is just a pyro burning his way through everything. I'm gonna have to leave my rescue ranger bolts. Just peg this guy repeatedly as I backpedal. He's gonna catch me again. And that's the point gone. So I've got my tally up now. Take tally, people. We might be able to hold this if I'm quick. I get walked out. Damn it, tally got broken. That guy with the direct hit just completely ruined. You're gonna get wrenched, you know that. Well, that's a losing round. I should have gone with the sentry first. I didn't realize we were going to get rolled that badly. Oh well. So I still got 11 streak gun. It's sitting behind somewhere here. Probably in the house. Never come in the house. Nobody ever checks the house. So that was a losing round. I might do one more. Well, that's half an hour. I might cut out the second round because it was kind of weak. No, I don't want to trade with you. Thank you. Right, do the telly. Get the sentry up.
Move him out!
I'm going to disregard the dispenser and telespot for now. So I'm just going to get the level 1 up quick. Because direct hit guy's coming. Scouts behind points. See, while you're doing this, no one's going to be paying much attention to you. 3, 2, 1. So it's covering slightly, and could have been done with being further forward. I'll take that metal though. Caught the scout out there, watch for the rollers. That direct hit guy. He does not like me, and is going to make my job very hard.
Hey boys, it's a spy.
I'm going to beat on this engineer. Hello. Nice dead ring. I got the direct hit again. Got him.
Thanks, mister. Get going!
Get the telly up here, I think.
Teleporter coming right up.
I'll go for another level 3. I'm level 1 here, quick.
Building a sentry.
Scout's being distracted. Damn it. I'm not going to leave my shots good enough. Nope. Ah, where is blue? Oh, red, sorry. Oh, they're all over the point while I'm getting cooked. They're going to get flanked on. Or the guy with the flog pyre is going to pop and just completely murder everybody from behind. I might cap this, though. Let's hit this telly for a bit. Oh, the flog pyre is there just walking forward and being unkillable because no one knows how to fire rockets throwing feet. Really, if people take the telly, maybe they move it slightly to the right.
I'm moving this.
Oh, that spy's tearing up. Oh, hi, scout. Keep being annoying when I might spawn one. I like to fix this telly. Someone's breaking it from the other end, so I'm just gonna keep hitting it. Grab more metal. So, as you can see, there's people on the other end of this just constantly spamming it out. I'm just gonna keep hitting it until they use a direct hit. And now it's level 1 again. So they've got a couple of people on their team with direct hits, which is making it very impossible for me to do much at the moment, but I will keep trying to do anything. And they've got mini sentries as well, and that guy is a comp player at least of some description. So he's playing MG. I've probably been stuck in. So look at the carnage out here. Hello. Hi, scout. Build here. So I've got slightly further ground, forward ground here, and it'll help kill attackers like this who decide to run into the sentry. And the team would get aggressive and actually get some presence at the point here. So I got level 2 up.
I'm moving this.
Just need to get it into a position where it's going to help cover. Which it will now. However, I do believe their team has completely wiped ours. The soldier scouts my left.
Mission ends in 30 seconds.
Doggone hell!
You get telly and dispenser as quick as possible.
Alert. The control
get the gun slightly further forward. Covering the point nicely.
Dispenser going up.
Do again that mal over there.
Well done.
Point's clear for now. See, there's only 24 seconds on the flock, but I've got a level 3 here. Don't build next to me. Please don't build next to me. Other side, interesting. I'm just going to keep this cover for now until the team gets further forward and starts supporting. Right here. Oh, rescue ranger, please! I missed. Engineer's helping. They're spamming from the upper cliff area, which is annoying. Can't keep this up forever, this guy up on there. Alright, this point should be relatively well locked now. Build! I actually need a teleport over into this group. We'll make it a dispenser in time.
Nice going,
keep face backed up. So yeah, I'll use these 2 rounds.
Nice
spot.
Hey,
yeah, well, it's gonna work out well for you. He did, David. He did. See, I've got a pirate harassing me with flares here. This is level 2.
Help!
So Telly's up. Dispenser's level 2. Telly's in an odd spot, wouldn't usually use that, it's just convenient. This is just covering the point nicely. It's out of sniper sightline bar from China. Which is that area over there.
Alrighty then.
Get that guy full health. And we've got a nice hold on this now, and try to hold it for another 60 seconds. Not miss my rescue rangers. I have one health, and it's down. Keep spy. Stay behind this and get help. Hopefully we can hold it. Get that guy to a wall. Build the sentry in a different spot this time. See, I've got the level 3 dispenser here now, so I've got a lot of health. He's fine. And the direct hit guy's just going to keep spamming me out, because he's being a douche. I'm just going to build over here. There's on the cliff now, so nobody expects it to be there. Didn't kill the scout though. That's level 2 now, that'll cover the point nicely. There's another dom. Could actually aim the rescue ranger. Whatever. Good enough. Hello. You're probably the one who's getting stupid fucking shots on me. And that was a decent demonstration of what a level 3 and or a mini sentry can do on Viaduct. I hope you enjoy, and I will post another disgusting thumbnail because I love doing it. Any feedback? Sure, whatever. I didn't really use the telespot as much as I wanted to. Thanks for watching, I guess. See ya.